Hey guys, it is Thursday night, it is hacking time, and I am ready to go. How are you guys doing today? I am doing fantastic. I cannot wait for tonight. I have got some cool stuff, and it doesn't look like that much of a change for the magic update. It doesn't look like that much of a change from what I showed last week, but believe me, there is a lot involved to get it happening. There was a little glitch that I was having with all of a sudden Terra's abilities all got like swapped around and changed, and it was some weird thing. And I tracked that down to a portion of the post-battle script where I had something reversed, and the end product was that the wrong offset was loaded when it was sending characters into the level up screen, when it was sending into the level up code. And so when it had the wrong offset, that means it was checking and altering a totally different set of RAM, which happened to coincide with Terra's ability list. So so all I had to do actually was just move one piece of code up a few lines, and that fixed everything. So a little oversight, that kind of stuff happens, but it's fixed now. And but in addition to that, some actual progress that I've made is I've got, hey, Lock Kirby, good to see you. The sound is skipping a bit. Man, I thought I had that fixed. Hold on. I will fix that. I'll try to fix that. Is that any better at all? Last time I did that, it helped. But let me know if that's helping at all. And was it all the sound, or was it just on the microphone? I believe it should just be on the microphone. Okay, cool. Cool. Yeah, this is. We got a new microphone because we've been having some issues, and this one's actually temporary. We have a much better one on the way, and I think part of it's the USB hub. I think part of it's probably the microphone. I don't know. Bunch of little things to track down and figure out. So I need to do some troubleshooting on my actual computer rather than just on hacking, apparently. But yeah, thanks for coming out. How you guys doing tonight? Let me hear from you guys. I need to move my chat somewhere more visible. Why don't I do this? Shrink that down a little bit. Let's do it this way. Let's do a pop out. And I changed some stuff on my layout. You'll notice I've got like a different text over here. I'm using some different stuff. I'm actually using Twitch alerts now, and that allowed me to get a better plugin for text, so that I don't have to use like a window for it any longer, which takes care of all that stuff for me. And then I've also got like a little pop-up when people follow, so we'll see if that happens. It doesn't happen super often, but yeah. Last day of your co-op is tomorrow? Cool, cool. What exactly do you mean by co-op? Co-op, like a co-op gaming thing, or is that like a specific term that means something that I should know what it is, but because I live in America, I don't use that exact term. For some reason, that's the idea that I'm getting. Also, hey, Mog. Cool, cool, cool. Or a housing thing? I don't know. But either way, we've got some cool stuff. So I settled on a list of abilities. So there's 4 new black magic spells, 4 new gray magic spells, and 2 new white magic spells. I've got it so that they sort into the magic list properly, and also they Use the proper startup animations, and I created animations for them, and those are fun to watch. So we're gonna show those off, and then we get into some map stuff. So for Children of Vector, I'm adding a couple little outposts since I'm taking Figaro Castle out. They're basically an internship. We get paid, nice, similarly to a normal job. Cool, that is very neat. Of course, if that's the end of your paycheck, that could be a problem, but are you going back to school, or do you have, like, are you moving into, like, a full-time position? But congratulations. Congratulations. You made it to the end. All right. Let's... let's load this guy. Get a little bit of sound for me. Let me know if you guys could double sound, because I've got my speakers and the microphone. But it shouldn't be. I've got it pretty low. The final boss battle of your internship. So let's look at some new abilities. Let's look at some new fun stuff. Alright, so let's check out some of these first and foremost. Alright, so I've got Morphear, which works similar to, I believe it's Ragnarok or whatever. And that's actually just using a real basic, like, snare for Mog's Dance. And a lot of these actually just borrow from other spells. So Wall here is like Big Guard, but only for one person. And I could change the color, but I didn't really feel the need to for that one. Blink is kind of cool. This one's a little bit custom. So it uses the quick animation, and then I added like that sway, like they're speeding up or whatever. But it's a quick animation in a different palette. 2 weeks of final boss. Yikes. And blind, you know what? And blind, I found something cool for blind that I can't believe I missed before when we were working on Vargas's eye gouge, which I will probably go back to Vargas and update his eye gouge to do something similar. So let's look at this. Hey DN, how you doing? I totally forgot about the little eyeballs. And so I just have like a little puff of smoke and the eyeballs that go away. No, don't kill it. Okay, it's dead. It died. That's right, I've got more spells, I'll show them. A whole pile of firmware. Oh, that sounds like fun. Oh, jeez. Yikes. Yikes. Man, one of them always escapes, like, right away. Alright, so let's, I made a renew. And renew is basically, a cure plus regen. Single target only. And so that's basically the regen animation in a different color. And heal is Asuna, or remedy, with a cure. And it's using the remedy animation, but within a different palette. Oh, really? Instead, they don't escape after the first one left. That's funny. I could fix that. Alright, so then I've got Drain 2, Virus, Octant, which is... see, I couldn't use Gravija because I didn't use Gravity or Graviga or whatever the heck the second one is for that. And so I had to come up with another one. And so since they're using Demi and Quarter, I decided to go with the same kind of thing, and so I made it called Octant, which is basically a full party gravity type spell. And this wasn't like my favorite one, but it worked out all right. It worked out all right. And so in addition to doing the HP based damage, it also removes float if that exists, which is actually gonna be more useful against the party than it will be against any monsters. Did Brave New World use those? I haven't played Brave New World, but they just seem, those two names just seem to make sense for what I was doing. Like, if you're gonna add white magic, you kinda can't, like, add more healing? there aren't like that many things you can do that would be specifically white magic and not gray magic, and so it was like I had to mix stuff. So it, but I guess that's what Brave New World did. So if so, then yes. If so, then yes. All right, and you guys have seen Drain 2 and Flood. I'll show them off in a minute anyway. In fact, I'm gonna go ahead and grab a save state. And then Virus is like a hyped out poison. And so it's like super fast and kind of all over the place rather than just a boop, 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 boop. It's like brrr, all over. So saved on economy of action. Or yeah, kind of, yeah. Exactly. And it's actually a smaller heal, but since these characters are like super maxed out, it doesn't matter anyway. Oh, see, and I'm not rewriting any damage formulas or anything like that. This is just supposed to be a magic update. And then Drain 2. And you can see everyone's getting their proper startup animation there. Oh, I guess I didn't have to do that. And Flood, which is still probably my favorite animation out of all the ones I made. That and Blind. But, I think Flood's still my favorite animation for all my custom spells. So those are the new spells. And they all work. I do have one bug to work out, and that is that the new spells, they don't turn gray when you don't have enough MP. And so I've kind of got to figure that out, how to fix the availability problem. But that's pretty minor. That's pretty minor. I will get to it, though. I am not going to release this without fixing that stuff, because that would bug me to release something that was stupid. Like, with as much work and as much effort as I'm putting into this, I'm going to make sure there's polish. So that means it's gonna have that stuff. Those little nitpicks, I'm gonna get to them. So that's what we've got going on with the magic update. And it's getting pretty big. It's getting pretty long. I believe I've got it open up here. Yep. Yeah. So this has gotten pretty large. So it's got. I also added the learning magic at startup when you first start the game. For Terra, and then when you when Celis, so I had to write a little bit for that. Finish getting the yes. You already saw the names were working. This was the check for the startup animation. So basically, I just wrote a function that checks to see if it's a spell in the spell list, and then if it is, now it's going to check a bit mask that I set up in here. So, we already have this, for the learn spells, we are using 8 bytes for a set of bits. 8 bytes for a set of bits that show you what magic you've learned. Well, I'm using a similar concept here. 8 bytes as a set of bits to show, okay, this is black magic. So, black magic are the bytes that fill up that space. Or the bits, rather. Gray magic are these bits. And the white magic are these bits. And so that way, when it's filtering in, it's checking for which one it is, and then sets the appropriate startup animation. Now, I use these also in the spell sorting when it's getting set up. And this I had to totally rewrite, because this is totally different from vanilla. In vanilla, all it does is it reads it and finds out what kind of offset it's supposed to have, and then moves it. This, I had to write something totally new, and I'm actually kind of proud of my logic for this. Is that instead of the table, yeah, like a bit mask, exactly. For anyone who does any kind of networking, it's like a subnet mask, or probably more appropriately a wildcard mask, well, that kind of thing. So instead of loading an offset for how far to move the spells, what it does is it's going to go ahead and it's going to load up what the starting location is for black magic, white magic, and gray magic for each of the configuration setups. And then stores black magic in 11, gray magic in 12, white magic in 13, and whatever leftover in 14. And so that way, if you don't want to have, if you want to have stuff that's specifically not black, white, or gray magic, then it can have its own that will it'll default to. Hey, Zatris, good to see you. Glad you can make it. I got stuff for you. You stick around. You don't go anywhere. I'm gonna get to the new map stuff soon. All right. So the first thing it does is it sets those beginning locations, and then I gotta go way down to find my code because there's a bunch of other stuff in the way. So you see here, this used to be a list of offsets, and now it's a list of starting locations. And so now what it does is it'll pull the spell. Oh wait, this isn't it either. I could have swore it was around here. Here we go. This is it. Right? Yes. Okay. So then the first thing it does, we've already got our, we've already got Y going into this, which is what the spell number is, the magic number is, not the attack number, because we don't need that yet. So that's the 0 through 3F for which spell it is. So we've already got that. And so we go ahead and we save that as something to check for. And then we run, oh no, I'm sorry. We find out what our byte offset, and then which bit in that byte to check for, to find out for, to check for a specific spell. All right. And then we basically load the black magic bits or bytes or bits, I guess, and check to see if that bit is set in black magic. If it's set in black magic, then it goes ahead and it puts it in the first black magic spot. Look right here where it loads X for 1-1. And that's going to be where it saves when it comes back out. That's where it saves its location, and then it increments that location. So that the next time it catches a black magic, it's going, all right, well, this is our location. So it starts here. Hey, James, glad you can make it. Good to see you. So it grabs it and then increments it so that the next one that comes along, and so that they just slowly fill up. Now, this does create a little bit of work for hackers that are going in and they want to customize this, but it is not hard-coded, which was what I was trying to get away from. I wanted to make sure it wasn't hard-coded so that you could change what spells you want in there and still have it do what it needs to do. When you change the number of black magic, white magic, and gray magic, it gets a little bit hairy, but this will all be documented, so anyone who wants to do stuff with it will be able to. It'll show you exactly what things you need to change for for each thing that you want to change. And another bonus of this, too, is if you want to remove a spell that's already in the middle of the spell list, like, say I wanted to take Fire 2 and turn it into another white magic spell, I could do that without screwing up the order of the magic list. I could do that and still have it filter into white magic, which is actually impossible in vanilla. You're kind of stuck. Unless you add it to the very end of black magic and shift everything else down and then fix all the other monsters so that they're calling the right spell, and then you change the other thing. So this is actually more flexible than vanilla. This is actually more flexible than vanilla. Oh, here it is. I think this is it. I think the one that I have up there needs to get erased, but I can do that later. So, I put a lot of work into this, so I'm going to take the time to show you what I did for my well-deserved pat on the back. I did that wrong. All right. So, on to more interesting stuff. I have a spiffy new editor. And I want to go to here. So for Children of Vector, I have my full expansion done for maps. 100% expansion. Well, not 100% as in 100% as long, but this is the full amount of expansion that is naturally possible in the game. And so you see down here, I have new map, new map, new map, new map, all these new maps in here. These are all completely editable and makeable. I can do things. I can add all of this stuff. That's all brand new stuff. And so I made a couple things. And I'm gonna keep working. I'm gonna work some more on the stream tonight, because like I said earlier, for those that may have missed that, because in Children of Vector, we are exiting Narshe after Figaro submerges, and so there's really nothing for us to do out here. And so you could just go down and go straight to down here, which will eventually be Figaro Pass. But that's literally going from like one dungeon to the next dungeon with no real break in between. There's nothing to do other than the beginner's room, which we'll do. But I wanted to add a little bit of something to throw in. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually adding a couple outposts. One will be here, and one's going to be over here. So this one's going to be called Figaro Outpost East or something like that. And so this is actually going to be impossible to walk by without seeing. So if you're walking by as close as you can over here, you see it. If you walk by as close as you can over here, you still see it. All right, so there's no way the player is going to miss this when they're walking by. And they'll see it, and it says East. And so the fact that it says East should give people the idea that maybe there's something in the West also. So it gives them a reason to walk around and explore. And there's going to be nothing like super exciting. There's going to be a merchant in one of them. And it'll give you a little bit of tidbits of lore. Just to kind of fill you in and just kind of give you something to do. You know, there's a reason to go there. So that's kind of the point of what I'm doing. And so that's kind of what I started working on. And originally I was just going to overwrite Figaro Castle. But in order to test the new maps, I went ahead and started making them a new map space. And so far they're working. They have not broken yet. Now I'm working up at the top, so we'll see. But let's take a look at the outpost. You can't see it there because I'm actually scrolled all the way down and over. Whoop! Here we go. All right, let's get rid of the exits, and let's get rid of layer 3 because that's not visible. So this is kind of the entrance of the first outpost. It'll be really tiny. It's not going to be anything big. You know, I'm just trying to whet my appetite a little bit on what it's going to be like to do map editing, because my first attempt at map editing was abysmal. But I'm getting ideas now. I actually have a plan for what I'm going to do with Figaro Pass, how I'm going to approach the level design and how to make it. But this is an actual brand new map. That I created. There will be eventually. I haven't put the NPCs in. I literally made this today, and so I've got the exits working, and it takes you inside, and I've got the first level of the inside. So there's gonna be two inside levels, and then you're gonna be able to come up to the roof. You know, James, I was thinking about asking you about that because you do such a stellar job with the level design stuff that you've been doing with Mario. If you were interested in doing stuff like that, you could have a very permanent job with Children of Vector doing map stuff. That is literally the one thing that is really like pressing on me, that is really holding me down from being able to like go and do and start making like serious content. So this is the first part, and all the way down here. And then I've got the first level of the inside made down here. All right, so then I made both of these basically from scratch. I did a little bit of copy and pasting to get a feel for it. And then I'll go from there. Okay, well this particular version of the level editor has been made specifically for Children of Vector. I had Mad work out the exits bug, and I don't know if anyone else noticed this, but every time I saved an exit that was larger than that went anywhere over FF, it would chop this bit up here, or this byte up here, and it would only save the lower level one. So I've got that fixed. Like, say I loaded, I did an exit to 127, Kefka's Tower inside. Where it would pop me out would be 2.7. Where it would actually save would take me here. And that's been around as long as I can remember. I can't fathom why that never got caught or fixed. And so I used to have to change that manually But since I was getting basically a custom editor, this is basically a custom editor, that works. I did have a problem today with importing. When you import, you have to like make other changes also in order for the imports to stick. And so if I import layer one and import layer two won't save properly. And so I had to import layer one, import layer two, and then like just draw over top of some of the layer two changes and then save it, and then it works. But yeah, it was a pain. I'm trying to figure out exactly what it is that causes the problem. And I might throw this at Matt and see if he can figure out what's going on with that, since he's been so fantastic about the rest of this. This is literally the seventh version, and that's not even an exaggeration of the editor, as we've been like slowly expanding and slowly creating more things. And the other thing that's nice about this is that you'll notice here too, if I don't know if you guys can read that. It's but it actually says here Figaro Outpost East and Figaro Outpost Inside. That is because Mad added an option for me to save the name of the map inside the editor. So that way I don't have to remember what's what. I can actually write it in there. Map expansion is open heart surgery for your ROM. It is going to it can totally break your ROM, but it is definitely worth it. Matt and I have talked a little bit about what it would take to automate that process, and mostly Madsiur's doing the legwork, obviously. I just kind of worked out the locations, but he was going to use Children of Vector as the template, and it basically takes up all the space. Everything basically gets moved to all the space after the ultra expanded 5-0 bank. Yes, I know, right? Golf clap, guys. Everybody golf clap for Mad. So when he sees this later, he's even around. Is he around? He's normally talking, so I'm assuming he's not around. But anyway. He's a genie. Oh man. You gotta rub him the right way. So if you guys want to see it, and I actually saved myself right below the tile. So we can actually go in here, and all the animations work. Everything works. Everything's solid that's supposed to be solid. So it's all here. It all exists. It all works. And we've got this. I might need to expand that the layer two. You can see you can't see. I can't move the mouse, and you can't see my finger pointing at it. But you can see where the edge changes from light black to dark black. That always bugged me. That always bugged me. I might do that. Oh, and that's another thing. I think I have to fix some physical properties, because as you can see, I can walk through the pot that way, but not this way. And also, when I go up here, I'm on top of the rail rather than behind it, which actually that might be. I might need to add some layer two stuff for that. I'm not entirely sure. So a couple things there, but this is all I've got, and this is what I'm gonna work on tonight. I'm gonna do some more stuff. So in the overworld, so this is the other thing I need to work on. Well, that's actually another whole big thing, because all of that stuff is handled in a different bank, and there would be a lot that would go into it, and there's a lot of hard coding to overcome in order to get that to work. So hypothetically maybe, but I don't know. We'll see. We will see. The stairs actually don't go anywhere just yet. They will. That's actually what I'm going to do tonight. I'm gonna make an upper level for this and hopefully add some NPCs. Am I missing? I feel like I'm missing a tile back there. It looks like it's dark. I'm missing like a layer one tile back there. Missing a layer one tile. All right, well, let's do things. That's what we're here for, right? So let's do it. Yeah, if I hide layer two, you see there's a gap back here. And I wish I could zoom in. Can I zoom in? Ha! Cool. I bet that's going to make this easier for everybody. All right, so I need this tile to look different. That layer one tile, I'm not entirely sure how to do that. Because this already requires a layer two tile. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to move that down. I'm going to move that down. All right, let's turn off that. I don't want that. Can I just drag you? No. I can only do that if I do this. No, I don't want that. I don't want that. What do you think you're doing? All right. All right, so let's go over here. I'm gonna grab my walkable physical tile and I'm gonna drop that there. All right, and late layer two, I need just a plain tile to go there. Layer one, I need my armor base to go here now. And then layer two, we'll drop that there and that there. And that will not look messed up. That will work much better. All right, and so I think there's a priority thing that I need to fix. And this, I'm not entirely sure what to make of it. Also, are there multiple pots? Because it bugs me that I can walk through that pot. And I definitely can't change... I don't think I should change the physical map, because that changes all the tiles. I need to figure out what I need to do in order to not get stuck there. Oh, good call. Well, whatever. Wait a second. Did my stuff just go back to... What just happened? Why is this here again? Did anyone know what just happened? Did anyone see that move? What just happened? All my stuff just got undone. All my stuff just got undone. What is wrong with this? That layer one and that layer one. Layer two, I want this, and that's, and that. And that. I'm gonna go ahead and save this now before it undoes itself again. Holy cow. Yeah, apparently I have to save it before I even change anything, before I move anywhere. I have to, I don't know. Well, that's good to know. All right, so I'm gonna change that to one because I think that's the most common one that I've seen. But you know what? That's visual. I think that's visual. That won't change the physical properties. You said you think there's a second pot? All right, well, that's a pot there. That's the one that I used. I see a bucket. And thing is, hypothetically, I should be able to get... Maybe I should just move the pot down here so that you can't... Well, that space is actually walkable down here. Well, that's how troubleshooting works, Atrus. So you did just fine. You did just fine. All right, I don't see another pot. If someone else sees another pot, let me know. If not, I might be changing it to like a bucket or something. Actually, the bucket's in the dark orange. That could be a very different kind of issue. Or we could do something that makes a little bit more sense, and instead of going behind it, I could use the... I think there's an impassable... I just need an impassable regular tile, which is this one right here. And I'm going to use that, and I'm going to make this a layer 2 object. Which is not writing. Alright, okay, well that's probably what I got to do. Alright, layer one, impassable tile. Layer two, pot. No, not a race. Not a race. Alright, maybe I need a different impassable tile. That might be a top layer tile. Need an impassable regular tile. The only one I see is this, but I think it's gonna write on top. It writes on top. Maybe they didn't. I don't know. Well, that's the thing. I copied this priority set, and I copied a lot of things directly from there to make sure that I was doing that. But say what now? You can stream, B-run stream, and commenting over him. Okay. All right. Good to know. Yeah, I can't put one back there that's not the right one. What I'm watching for is I'm waiting for one of these things to... I'm waiting for one of these to change. Nah. Oh man. What's up, Mad? Stop trying to leech my followers. I'll punch you in the throat. Don't test me. All right. Yeah, let's go look at Figaro Castle. Figaro Castle inside. Let's zoom out. And someone tell me if you see a pot. Actually, don't see any pots. Yeah, there are no pots. Let's go in one, but I don't see any pots. Which might be a thing. Maybe I'll use a crate. I could just put a crate there. I just wanted to have something. Oh, no. Oh, I see. The names go out a certain distance. Okay. I might need to edit. Need to edit my... Well, you know what? Let me slide that over. In the right spot. All right, that'll have to work for now. I'll have to shrink that down a little bit later. Well, I don't know why they put a pot in that tile in that graphic set then. WTF. Oops, not that one. That one. All right, well, we're not going to use the pot then. Because it causes issues. I could put the pot up on top of something, but why? Figaro has a pot at the bottom left jail cell. Okay. Oh, well, if it's at the bottom, though, then it's probably because you can't get under it anyway. Is nuclear signs on the original tile set? Where? Where is this? I do not see the nuclear sign. You mean like the little symbol thing? What? 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 Outside. I don't know. All right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to change that. And I guess I can use that. But I'll probably have to use it. Well, that would give me the same problem because that doesn't actually take up a whole thing by itself.
Let me try it, and maybe if I'm lucky, that will not be passable. It won't be one of the ones that you walk into and get stuck. So let's save it. And let's give it a shot. You know what I'm gonna do? Never mind. Oops, just bonking my mic. That doesn't look as good. Huh. It does the same thing. Piece of monkey. Okay. Piece of monkey crap. All right. Where am I going to? I'm not going to that. I'm going to this. Okay. Well, I guess we don't need a pot. I could put a treasure chest there, but like an open one. Chocobo stables. Chocobo stable. Inside. That's a different... It's using a different tile set, though. So it's going to have a different physical map. But it does do the same thing, at least as far as that's concerned. So it uses... Oh, sneaky! I see. If you use one that's impassable from the bottom beneath it... Exactly, Odal. Exactly. That's what it looks like right here. See? There you go. I think you might have the chops, Odal. Or Odal. I'm not sure how to pronounce that. Let me know if I'm doing it wrong. But you may have the chops for this. You may have the chops for this. Oops. What am I doing? Not that one. All right. So do we have one of those? Do we have a regular... What does that look like? What actually is that? That is a different kind of thing. All right, so I'm looking for a standard block that it will not allow me to pass upwards. Here's one that won't allow me to go up or over, and I believe it is... No, it does have an edge. Anyone without an edge? Maybe if I can put a layer two that goes on top of it that will not appear. So let me go ahead and get that down. I can go ahead and change that. All right, and so what I'm looking for is one of these that's not going to appear on top. So ideally something like that, but I have a feeling that's going to appear on top, and it is. Did that work? No. And that's going to do the same thing. Is that the same one that I just did? Whoops. Ooh, that may have been it. Haha. All right, save the ROM. Let's do it again. All right, hold on. Don't show that again. Ha. There. Now hopefully that won't be a thing. All right, let's try it. Ha ha. Amazing. That's how it works. Sweet. You missed everything, Funky. Everything. No, I'm just kidding. I'm just working on some new maps. I showed off some stuff for the magic update earlier, but this is what we're doing. We are doing some new maps. This kind of stands out like a sore thumb, so I might put someone over here. And then a chair over here. And then I've got to add some NPCs I'm going to make upstairs. All right. That is the plan. That is the plan. All right. Let's get back in over here. And what I need is new space. So let me grab this. How big is this? What I'm going to do right now is I'm just going to actually make it like right next to the other one. And this is going from 45 down to 59. So if this is 86, then that should go down to, wait, 5 to 9, 14. So this should go from, 41, excuse me, to 7, right? Two more. That, I do believe. I'd like it to be roughly the same size for my outline. It's one of those things I'm going to be weirdly picky about. All right, and so this one, in fact, I really should just copy it and then edit it, which I can actually do. I like the fact that there's like a copy paste feature in this. So do this, copy. And it copies per layer. So starting with layer 2, I paste that. I can actually drag it right down there. And then we'll highlight that again. Go to layer 1, copy and paste. And that's there too. All right, and so what I'm gonna do different is a bunch of things actually. So let's start by deleting a bunch of this stuff. What I want to do is I'm actually going to make a wall that's going to be one block higher. And so you're going to come up over here. This is where you're going to come out from the stairs, up from downstairs. And you'll be able to go around, and then the door going to outside will be right here, kind of in the middle. So there'll be a space here, and then I'll put a couple beds over here for where the guards sleep. Well, there you go. Only Vector has toilets. Good point. Good observation. So I'm going to take that. Actually, no, I'm not going to do that that way. All right. Let's start copying things, okay? So, or let's start writing things, rather. All right, so I'm going to actually pick up my... You know what? Actually, I will leave it. I will leave it there. Except it's going to be over here now. There we go. And then that one, I think, right? Yeah. All right, and so the physical layer for over here, it's going to be a bunch of garbage. Which is actually all going to be wall stuff in a second. In fact, layer 1. Got this. Impassable. Well, there you go. You know, that's a really good point. I need to be paying attention to those little details. I just weirdly got really kind of like, oh my goodness, I should be paying attention to this. All right. So how do I want to depict? All right, so layer 1 over here should be basically filled up. And I think I already did that, right? Yeah. Except for like one tiny little thing over here. How do you normally come from like downstairs to upstairs? It's weird. I see this a million times when I'm actually like playing the games. But then when I get to making stuff, all of a sudden I'm like, how does that work? So what I need to do... Let's get to Figaro Castle inside. And I think that should work fine. I think I can just grab that. Only this will be wall instead of railing. That's right, because this is the part that I need. In fact, let's do... Oh, come on. Ugh, so inconsistent. That's what I want. So let's copy this down here. Figaro Castle inside. Let's paste it. And see that, actually that's gonna look a little bit weird. I'll have to cover up a little bit more than that, I do believe. But what I can do is I can just cover that all by layer two. That can all be layer two. Because what I just copied was layer one. Once I do that, I've got what I want. Now that looks really funny right there, because I overwrote a bunch of stuff. But I'm gonna fix it. First of all, what am I doing? First of all, I think I want it something like that. And so we use that. We use that. And then let's get back to layer one. Oh, you know what I'm missing, actually? I need some more wall there. Because that's wall. You know what? Let's, Skum. Maybe I could just make it like a side entrance. Just for the sake of space. Let me think about this. It's not too bad. It's not too bad. Because the farthest I want the wall is about that size. So what do I have over here? I just distracted myself. There we go. For some reason, that was bugging me. I don't know why. Not any of this mess over here. It was that tiny little thing down at the bottom that was bugging me. So what I want is I want like a wall here. And I want the stairs, if possible, to be in as a part of that. So let me paste this. I can't paste the stairs again. They're not there any longer. All right. I can paste these stairs, though. It's fine. It's fine. And I probably don't even need the whole set of stairs. Right? What I want is... The thing that bugs me is everything. I think I want about that. Think one about that. Now the wall in this instance is going to change. But this should be the top layer of where I want to start walking. So hypothetically, if I want a wall to start there, then that is the lowest. Then that's where that needs to be. Okay. And that needs to be somewhere like this. And what I want to do is lift it up one more. But I just don't think so. Because if I'm here, like 1, 2, 3. But 4, 5. See, this, like 5 is about where the wall starts. 5 down from here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'd have to put it here. Got to put it like there. I don't really want to do that. Just making all sorts of mess over here. Just color it all. What? Why did that not work? Why is that blanking it out? I literally have something selected to draw, not erase. Okay. Alright, let's erase a bunch of things. Let's just get rid of it. Layer 1 gone, layer 2 going away. Alright, so layer 1. That is my... That is my backdrop. Okay, that is my backdrop. Go. Okay. This needs to be my base level. Let's start with a square and go from there. Okay. Alright, so that means this is where I'm walking. Start of my walkable tiles should happen here. And then go around over here. Yeah, I should have done it this way to begin with. I'm not entirely sure why I didn't. Whoops. Okay. That's my box. That's my box. If where you're entering is right here, because yeah, you can't get quite on. Oh, I've got that too. I gotta get rid of that too. There we go. Get rid of that just because it's extra. All right. Alright, so I would like a space here in the middle. Now hopefully that doesn't need to come down too far, because if this is like the top of my stair area, what does the top of the stairs look like? Because I actually need that. I mean, I would like to see the top of the stairs if possible. But what does that look like? Let me see if I can just copy a very tiny chunk. Figaro Castle inside. I just want this. I just want this and maybe that. So those six squares are all I want. Can I get it? No, of course you're gonna grab 8. But I can live with that, because I need an outside portion of that also anyway. Alright. So layer 1 and layer 2. But which part's layer 1, which part's layer 2? Yeah, so I'm gonna have to come back twice. All right, so I'm going to copy this. All right, and what part is the top part that's walkable? You stand here when you're in, right? Can't stand there. So you come in here and then you go down. Yeah. All right, so let's copy this. And if I paste that sucker, I want that right about there, right? No, that did not work the way I wanted it to. Hold on, can I paste again? Well, did that work? That might have worked. I can't tell. Because I think I can walk... Shoot. Let's erase that and try again. Let's drop it down one. Let's drop that down one. All right, Figaro Castle inside. I need to grab the same 8 bytes. I did it. But in layer 2, let me turn that physical properties off. You can copy that. Paste you and drop you right on top. Okay. All right. So that should, you know what? I'm not sure, because obviously I can walk across here without it pulling me down. I think this is traversable. So I might be moving that whole thing up, but real quick, I'm going to test it. So let me go down here. Let me go to the exits. Hold on real quick. All right. Exits. Insert. What am I doing? Get off of that. And you're going to be... Shoot. I don't know what the actual square you end up standing on is. Not that. This? That's the one that split. I think that works. I think that's what it is. And anyway. Where that'll take you is inside, and I'll just drop it right here, which is 1237. All right, real quick. Oops, man, I keep hitting my that thing. Oh no, that looks right. Nah! Oh, dagnabbit. I had this happen once before where I had to do it twice, and when I went back and looked, it was one off, and then I changed it again and it worked. Actually, no, that does say the right one. Oops, let's save it here. Right, exit, Figaro outpost inside, 1237. Save ROM. All right, let's try again. There we go. All right. So this, I think I can walk on. No, I can't walk there. But I can't walk in that. Actually, you know what? That actually doesn't bother me that much. Maybe I could just leave this part here. It should drag me down, though, shouldn't it? That's kind of weird. But that doesn't bother me that much, because what I could do, hypothetically, is just have the exit appear right here, and then just block out this area with the dark color. That's fine. That's what I'll do. I'll just leave this. I mean, I would have liked to have had, like, where it starts going down, but that's actually really minor, all things considered. But why didn't it pull me down? I'm actually really curious. Isn't that the way it works? And it is here, so I actually can slide this whole section up as well, by the way. So layer 1, slide you up. And layer 2, slide you up. So that way I can go back to here. What I don't have is anything that appears like this. But I could make all of this hypothetically dark, which I think was what I was going to do anyway. Right? What I'll do is I'll just move that one closer. And that can actually be layer one. Now, what do I do if I want it to go multiple directions? Is there one that branches both left and right? Never mind. I'm a crazy person. Because I've got to have like a little loopy kind of thing. And then that should be that. And then I just need to set the top of the rail, which is a place, maybe. What is it supposed to look like? I don't even know. Like that. I wonder if the thing that I'm missing is the top rail. Maybe I should move that back down and use the top rail. It's fine. I can just have it stop here. I can make that the exit. Yeah, that's what I'll do. Okay. And then that's a pretty solid turn. And that'll be a pretty solid turn. And that'll be a pretty solid turn. Now I need a wall in there. In fact, I don't think I've got one that goes all the way around in one chunk, which would be really nice. If I'm going to add a wall, otherwise it's like a really thin. Well, I guess that's fine, I guess. I can work with it. This is supposed to be just kind of like a common area anyway, and I'm probably only going to put one bed in there, which all the guards will have to share. All the guards are just going to have to share the one bed. And then what does the doorway look like when it goes up? I need one of the stairs that leads up from this angle. I mean, I could just have another set of stairs over here going this way, but the way it looked in the castle when I looked at it before was that it goes up this way. I think that's this here. Which is that and that. And then what's the top look like? You know what? This sounds like a job for copy and paste. Figaro Castle inside. I think like that. But the one in particular I was looking at was this one. So what I want is that. Layer one. Which is the entirety of that, which is good. All right. So let's copy this. Grove outpost inside. Yeah, here we go. All right, paste. And if that's the ceiling, then, woo, that's a lot. No, it does need to be, shoot. How am I gonna fit all this stuff? WTF. Yeah, yeah, man. That's how you do it. Copy and paste. That's how I became the superstar that I am. No, seriously, I'm much better at editing things than doing things from scratch. Guess I got like a little curtain here for some privacy, but again, there's only going to be one bed and like four guards, so I'm not entirely sure how I'm going to handle that. I guess I could put one bed here, and one bed here. And max it out. But the bed is actually three tiles wide. So no, that will not work. That will not work. So there's only going to be room for one bed. And I don't even think you'll be able to climb into it. Hands off James White. I call dibs. I call dibs. Honor the dibs. This is already super tight. I guess I'll put some other stuff up here and pretend like they go to a house or something like that and they don't live here. I think that's what I'm gonna have to pretend. Put that there. All right. That's a good baseline, right? That works for me. So let's insert an exit. Can I move that one down? I know this is a weird nitpick, but if the exits are in the wrong order in the way that they make sense in my mind, it will bug me. Get rid of that. Drag you down here. So you are going to go there. Okay, because I can't walk any further than that. And where you're going to drop me is right there. So 1249. Facing west. Okay. And then insert one more. You're going here. And you are going to outpost east. I don't know which way is going to make sense. I guess north. And it'll be somewhere around 8-5, maybe? My best guess. I'm going to save twice. In fact, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go check on this. 8-3. And then I'm going to go back and see how the exits got screwed up. Oh, they didn't. Look at that. Figaro outpost. That's Figaro outpost inside. All right. Oops. Yeah, I know there was an error starting to save. I didn't do it. What's up, Jackimus? Making some new maps. Because I have, like, a bajillion new maps I can make. Alright, let's see if these actually worked. Oh, that brought me to the wrong spot. Alright, well that worked. Ah, all right, I gotta fix some visuals. I gotta fix the top. I don't think I had planned to walk on the top at the beginning, apparently. All right, well, I gotta fix that. Gotta fix that. All right. Oh, I need to fix this one also. So you are now going to drop the character off at 1532. Oh, I'm going to have to change all of these too, by the way, because... Well, actually, you know what? Those actually weren't visually in range of each other. So I could actually hypothetically leave those right where they're at. Anyway, so it's going to 1532 now. Not that where it's going. It's going to 1532, and you'll be facing east. Save. Double save. Thrice saved. Okay. So that should fix those. So let's go ahead and take a look at this. Now, I should be able to walk anywhere there, and I can. And I can. So, what should be layer one should all, and this should all just be the regular traversable tile, which I believe is that one right there. Okay. Let's turn you back on. Oh, right, because I've got those also. That's fine. Okay, that's not what I wanted. And yet that's traversable. Hmm. I'll have to change that. Okay, so layer one. All these. Ah! Shoot. Let's get rid of those last couple. Alright. And then the dark traversable tile. Let's go here, here, and here. Alright. So let's go to layer two. Let's delete all the layer two around here. I can't see it, but I know it's there. Oh, wait. And in layer one, I need some non-traversable tile also. Something. There should be like a regular, hopefully a regular ground somewhere that's non-traversable. I'll use the dark one, I guess. And you're gonna take up that spot. See, look at all this extra stuff I did. See, I still got some layer two over there. Man, sometimes stuff just doesn't go away. Just go away. Leave me alone. There we go. All right, so now going back over here, layer two. This is layer two so that I can walk behind these. All right, so if I get rid of layer two, that's all that should happen. All right, if I get rid of layer one, that's all the walkable area. All right, and last thing, but not least, grab my little exit. It's gonna go here. Outpost inside. Shoot. Something like 3713 or something. Facing the south. I want him to appear like right here. Probably not up here. I think right here would be good. 1237. 1237. You there. 1237. All right, let's save it. Figaro Outpost. Cool. And I'll show you guys what I want to do, what I want to use for the overworld for this. I just need to figure out how to edit that. Hey, aww. That's alright. That's okay. I can figure that out. Okay, I gotta figure that out too. Oh, that's not supposed to be walkable. That's right, we're getting there. We are getting there. I just need to make that stuff. If I use the layer 1 versions of those, of all of that stuff, I believe that will work. Right? Because I should always be on top of layer 1. Well, no, that's actually not true. Because you can walk, like, underneath of it. And that might be what it thinks is happening. But then it thinks you're on top of this one. Bullshit. I mean, bullcrap. Alright, but that's alright. Progress. Progress. Stuff's working. We're getting there. Okay. Now, it looked like I was behind this either way. In fact, now that I'm looking at it, those tiles were layer 1. That was layer 1. Those were all layer 1, and I was stuck behind them. Maybe I shouldn't go up there. Yeah, I know, right? Wedge is getting impaled. He's just trying to explore. Leave the poor man alone. All right. So I'm ending up behind a bunch of layer 1 stuff and on top of a bunch of layer 2 stuff. So instead, maybe I can use the regular non-traversable layer 1 tile I was using. And also, I could still walk down there, even though that tile is supposed to not be traversable according to my physical field. You could go, you know what, you can go on top of the top one. You can go up here. So how does that work? What do you use? That's all layer 1. And I use exactly the same. I use priority set 1 just like it used. Well, you know what? I'll double check that, but I'm pretty sure I use priority set 1. To make sure that, because this is right here. Half scrolling, shift, all the rest of that stuff, I'm pretty sure it doesn't have anything to do with that. I'm pretty sure this is it right here. Level editing is hard. Oh my goodness. And this is like the easiest thing I will be doing. Unless I can rope James into doing it for me. Yeah, priority set 1. Maybe there's another one. Or maybe it's using these ones? And I was using this one? There's so many things. Look. Those are the same tile. But this is the one I used, and I bet this is the one that I need. So let's do this. Let's do all those. Make sure none of that's layer 2. Okay. All right, and now I need those replaced. What to do about that? Maybe these? I don't know what the ones on top are supposed to, probably like that. And then I just use a dark layer 2 for there. Ah, And a light layer too for there. So that might fix that. I still need to figure this out over here, though. I mean, WTF. Well, let's see where we're at. Let's see if that did anything for us. I have to save state when I get over here, so I don't have to keep doing this. Hey! Alright. Alright, I found something working here. Almost there. It's just this left. I can walk down into that space I shouldn't be able to walk into. Oh, you know what? Actually, I think that was. I think this is the part that's... I think maybe is supposed to look traversable, but it's not. Like, I go behind that part. I think that's what it is. So I need a different layer... for that. Okay. I'm really hoping 0 and 7F are fine, but after, like, the exits... The level edit, honestly, the level editors are a bit buggy. Mine works better because I've had a lot of personal attention on it from Mad. But yeah. Yeah, sometimes you gotta like save stuff and then save it again, and you can't like do anything else. Like, make sure you save after every like everything. Well, didn't you expand your... I don't know. This has expanded all the things. Like, way past feasible expansion. Physical field. Oh, no, that is supposed to not look traversable. So it really is this part that's letting me travel on it that it's not supposed to. Well, then what do I do? I'll make it a wall. I'll just use this. I'll just use more of that. Which is what? This one? That one there. And I'll go back to layer 2 here. Oh, that writes on top of it. Huh. That layer 1 takes priority. Now, this is one I ended up behind. Was physical and I... Well, I guess that doesn't really matter. But that's all, again, showing up on top of. Why can't I just use the one that I want to use? Why did you have to make that? Return of the Duck Stallion. What's the problem you're having with Rot DS? I guess I could maybe lower that and then something. Oh man. Maybe dinner and some wine. What are these things? Well, that looks like different versions of these. They're also not physical. Ah, nope. That's a different thing. I need more. Wait, what? I think I already discovered I can... I should be able to walk behind that anyway, so I think if I use that other one, that should be okay. just this part that I keep walking on that I can't find a layer two that it doesn't. All I need is any non-traversable square that I can put behind those that doesn't show up. It's not a huge deal, but it bugs me. So hypothetically, let's just get jiggy with it. Let's just grab one of these black ones. Hopefully this is actually a non-traversable square. This I got working. Oh, now I can't walk on that at all. Not that that's the worst thing in the world, but it's very obvious that I'm not walking all the way down. Well, that's annoying. Oh, but you know what? You know what? Since I discovered there is that second option, maybe, just maybe, first of all, layer two. Maybe, just maybe, I can use my regular layer one because these are the ones I want to walk on. And then, shoot. No. Nope, this is the same problem I was having. This is exactly the same as where I started. I could do a non-fan one. All right, I think at the end of the day, I might just have to, I might just have to deal. Oh no, I'm on layer two. That's the one I want. No. No, wait, but the problem I was having was that I was showing up on top of it. Urgh. To kick somebody in the face. All right. Oops, make sure I save it on the actual editor. Pretty sure I'm back where I started. I want to be behind these, but not be able to walk down. Actually, look, that is already where I want to be. So all I need is a non-traversable square here. I don't need to worry about layering. I just need a square that I can't walk on. Okay. I can do this. Dagnabbit. I'm going to do this before I end for the night. Dagnabbit. Okay. So we've got this. And this. Okay? The problem that I had last time is I think I put it up here or something. Oh, that's no good. Sorry about that, James. I think when I did that, it didn't work, but I may have been trying to do too many changes at once and missed something. Yeah, I can still walk down there. It's not actually non-traversable when I do that. Right, I need something that's actually non-traversable. Let's try the one beneath it. Oh, you know what? Maybe I could do, maybe I could look for something like we had on the other one where the square above it is, you can't go down. Maybe I could do something like that. Hey, lady! Good to see you. Glad you could hop in. I'm making new things. But if I do that, actually, I need both layers here to be what they are. So actually, I can't change that. Never mind. I'm gonna stick with what I'm gonna stick with the approach I'm going with right now until I find one. Is there another piece of information that I'm? Is there something that actually says that? Oh, I found one. There we go. All right. There we go. Jeez, who would have thought that of all the stuff we did, this was going to be the thing that caused the biggest problem? Alright, let's see if we go back downstairs properly. We do. Alright, so now I just need to add some stuff in here. And we'll be done. You know what? Need to change that. The little liner ends kind of abruptly. Nitpicks. Check, you can check the physical properties. Where? Oh, there we go. There we go. Got it. Thank you, Mike. That's probably the best way to do that. Oh, you know what I should do? I should put this here. So it looks like an end piece. Except it's not actually a corner. Can I add that thing without making it a corner? Oh, no, never mind. That's the next piece up. Okay, that should work, though. Right there. That'll look good. There's a pot and everything. See, we have all the things. All the things. This just kind of looks like random crap strewed about, so I'll make this look a little bit more like someone actually did that, like planned. Like it's actually planned rather than just, I don't know, it looks like someone just like threw up on it and that's what it is. So I'll make it a little bit more coherent looking and then add a couple pieces up here and NPCs in the dialogue and that'll be it for this one. Then we'll make the other one. I'm surprised how long it took to finish that out, just to do those two levels and the exits. All right, well, send me your first check, and I'll make sure the previous tenants are out. You know, actually, I was thinking about making a joke about the outpost being air-conditioned. All right, real quick, I want to show you guys what I want to do, and I got to figure out how to do it. I have to figure out how to do it. I need to edit just one of these tiles, okay? Because I don't have Figaro Castle, but I do need to put something in the desert, and I need to edit one of these tiles. Now, my original thought was to change something in the graphics set, but the problem with that is the fact that the graphics set also influences DOMA, and I need DOMA. Like, DOMA's supposed to be there. So, each of these tiles, though, is made up of subtiles. And so what I would like to do is change one of these guys to look like this. And now it's its own little self-contained thing. And I should be able to hit update here, and you see up here it actually changes, but it doesn't actually save. And so then I could save it like that. And then I've got a tiny little outpost. And it doesn't look awkward or anything. Like, it's the perfect size, perfect fit, goes right in. But I can't actually change those properties. So that's what I'm trying to check. That's what I'm trying to track down now. So that I can have an outpost here and an outpost over here somewhere. But ideally that's what I'm going for. That's what the outpost is supposed to look like on the world map. And if I save that, you'll see that it's actually going to look nothing like that. Because I can't actually change that, apparently. You found the answer. And you see, it still looks like the top corner. And that doesn't look good. Everything is in the tile graphics. Oh, awesome. Well, then we'll work with that. Ah. Yeah, I've got to fix her startup animation. Cool, cool, cool. So everything is in the tile graphics. I mean, I did see you guys chatting about it a little bit on Discord. Why don't you cover her so she doesn't die? And of course, Wedge is numb. Yeah, actually, I probably gotta pack up too. I mean, that was the main stuff. I was gonna work on the other tower, but I ended up working on the inside instead. So there is garbage at the top. I didn't even get that far. So, all right. So when it's decompressed, that first 400, the first 400 bytes, or 400 bytes, not 400. The first 400 hex 400 bytes, which makes sense because it's 4 and then it's a 16 by 16 square and then 4 mini tiles for each one. So if I math it out, I should hypothetically be able to figure out which one it is and how to change it. So that's the plan. That's the plan. And they compressed a pallet. Well, cool. Well, then I will do that, and I will get myself some outposts made. And you see, you can't pass by it without... Oh, actually, you know what? If you pass by all the way north, you can still not see it. So I might have to move it a little bit. Oh, yeah. Yep, it is a Final Fantasy Tactics reference. So actually, if they cut it this close, they won't see it. So maybe I'll put it right here instead. So that way they see it there. Oops. Wedge is about to die. It's alright, Wedge can heal himself. As long as he doesn't get killed. Don't die! Yeah, I'll lift it up a little bit. The little frame they use to show you how big the screen isn't quite accurate. Well, there you have it, guys. Some map editing, some new spells, good stuff. Good stuff happening. So that's where I'm gonna wrap it up for the night. Thank you guys so much for coming out. I'll see you guys next week. Hopefully, I've got some staycation happening this week. Hopefully, I'll get some good hacking time in. The plan is to try to bang out the rest of the magic update. So then I can move on to more serious stuff with Children of Vector. Gonna get some more map stuff done. Gonna get some more event stuff done. I'll find something exciting to do. Also, check out the forum. There's a new contest up, short story contest. Also, a forum game to go with it, where we're just going to be kind of putzing around and doing a play-by-post story, where it's just every person who posts just adds to the story. So get on there, do that, and I will see you guys next time. All right, have a good night and happy hacking. All right, talk to you later.